Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today we are going to learn V-Ray two-sided material. It makes the material translucent and allows the light to pass through it. We use this material to simulate thin translucent surfaces like paper, curtains, leaves, etc. Before I start this tutorial, I have a request to all my fans. If you like my videos, then please watch the full video in the browser and support the channel. Let's quickly see what is in the scene first. I had done my lighting using HDRI and dome light. Important info. It is important to note that in order to get the proper effect, the geometry needs to be one-sided, that is not a box or a shell. The material will give the best result when assigned to a single-sided object, like planes, extruded splines, etc. Otherwise, it can lead to a much longer render time. Let's render the scene with lights off. In this video, we will turn this table lamp light on and apply realistic translucent material to this lampshade using V-Ray two-sided material. Now let's quickly apply V-Ray MTL material to this lampshade. Now turn on the lamp light and render. You can clearly see that the light cannot pass the lampshade because the material we have applied is not translucent. To make the lampshade translucent, we will make a V-Ray two-sided material and apply it to the lampshade. Now connect the V-Ray MTL material we have previously created to the front of the V-Ray two-sided material. Render and compare. V-Ray MTL material, V-Ray two-sided material, MTL material, two-sided material. We can clearly see that the light is passing through the lampshade. Now we will look at the V-Ray two-sided material parameters. Front material. These are the front side polygons of your mesh. Means this side in this case. Back material. These are the back side polygons of your mesh. By default, it is disabled, which means that V-Ray will use the same front material for back material as well. If you want to use a different material for the back side, then check this box and use another material here. But mostly we use the same material for both sides. Translucency. It controls how much you want your object to be translucent. Light gray color will pass more light, while dark gray will pass less light. Let's see some examples. Change the color to 240 and render. Compare it with our previous result. You can see when the translucency has 128 value versus 240 value. That's dark gray and that's more bright gray. Next, change the translucency value to 30. That is your dark gray color and render again. Compare it with our previous result. translucency value 240, translucency value 30. 240, 30. You can see when the value is 30, less light is passing through the lampshade. Hopefully this is clear to you. But I will recommend to use textures to control translucency color. Quickly load a bitmap here and render. This is the texture that I have used in my translucency. You can clearly see less translucency or less light passes at dark gray color, while more light passes or more translucency at light gray colors. When this value is 100, only texture is working. When this value is 0, only color is working. I will set it to 50. If you set it to 50, both texture and color will set the translucency. Multiply by front diffuse. When enabled, the translucency is multiplied by the diffuse of the front material. Turning for single sided. Turning this option off is not recommended, so simply ignore it. I hope that this tutorial was helpful for you guys. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love this tutorial, subscribe to my channel, share my videos, keep creating guys. And especially watch the full tutorial on the browser and support this channel. Thank you guys.